thousands of people go lost every year in wilderness environments. Around 25% are either never found or when they are found, they're hurt. So if someone is lost in the wilderness, we would like to not only deploy humans, as we already do, but we would like to deploy aerial vehicles in concert with human teams. And this is not about replacing human teams with aerial robots. It's about complementing human teams, because we have trained experts that are really great at finding lost people and extracting them. So you cannot replace that capability. But with an aerial robot, we can cover a lot more ground. And we have different sensors that can supplement a search. So that's at a very high level. What we're looking at is deploying autonomous aerial vehicles to support human teams. And there's a lot that goes into that when it comes to the autonomy. That's really the key here, because we're not looking at remotely piloted aerial vehicles. What we would like to do is have the aerial vehicles make decisions for themselves. So we equip all of them with high quality thermal cameras for two reasons. Number one, we can see hot bodies. If I wanted to differentiate between, say, a person and a tree, a thermal camera will help tremendously with that. But more importantly, we're tackling what is really a tough problem, is in wilderness environments, you have to deal with the trees, you have to deal with the canopy. Trying to see through the canopy completely is a bit tough, but with thermal, with sparse canopy, you can actually see somewhat through the canopy and see those hot bodies. They do cooperate. So that's another big problem that we're solving, is the information problem. So with more vehicles, you gather more information, and not only do you have to process that information, but you have to move that information between vehicles. Because if the vehicles are separated by large spatial scales, it helps for them to know what the other vehicles are doing. That's why the search and rescue problem really turned into a great domain for a lot of really tough research problems that are cross-discipline. So we have communication types of problems. We have information processing types of problems. We have computing types of problems. We have autonomy problems. We have modeling problems. So we're creating new search models, new lost person models, so we can try to predict what a lost person may do in a wilderness environment. So it's really intersecting a lot of tough and interesting research problems. I think we have a mixture for a very good search and rescue solution.